In this video, I'm gonna show you how to screen record on your Mac laptop or desktop for free using software you already have installed onto your computer. I'm also gonna show you how to record the audio inside of the computer for the videos or music that you are listening to while screen recording, all using free software. Coming up.
You gotta just press record.
Hey, my name is Nolan with Think Media, and Kathina asked us on Facebook how to record computer screen content, what software to use for doing this. Kathina, thanks for asking that question. Now, I only have Apple products, you know, with my laptop and computer, and so I am going to be using that and showing you some free software if you have a MacBook. For the first part of this video, I'm actually gonna be filming my screen with a camera because until I can actually screen record, I can't show you what I'm doing. So, I'm gonna pull out the camera and show you exactly how I set this up so that you can screen record for tutorials or whatever you'd like to screen record. So to find QuickTime, all you gotta do is hit Command Spacebar, and that's gonna pull up this spotlight search, or you can go over here to the right corner, hit this little magnifying glass, and from here, we're gonna search for QuickTime. Once you see it on the screen, you can click on it twice to open it up. This one is gonna pop up and we can close this. And what we're gonna wanna do is hit File, go to New Screen Recording. Now this is exactly what we use for Think Media tutorials. When I record an editing program or anything like that, I'm using this. You can record as long as you'd like, as long as you have the space on your computer to store that video file. Now down here at the bottom of the screen, we have some options for our screen recording. And so these three actually right here are for taking a screenshot, and we wanna do a video recording. And so I'm gonna go over some of these options here. First of all, I have it set to record the entire screen. If you'd like to record a selected portion, you can click that. And then once you hover over the actual screen, you can drag this out and it's gonna kind of keep that same brightness, but darken everything else around it so that you know exactly what is in your shot when you are recording. I've used that a few times, but typically I click record entire screen, and then in editing, I might crop something out. But for this, we are gonna leave it at record entire screen. Now over here we have options, and the top it says save to, and so we can tell it where we want it to save to. I want mine to save to my desktop, and so then I'm gonna open the options back up again. A timer, this can count you down. If you want to do that, you can. I don't need that, so I'm gonna leave my timer at none. And then for microphone, we can just leave it on built-in microphone, and I'm gonna kind of show you what some of these are that I've added later in the video to show how you can set these up so that you can record the actual internal audio of your computer. But typically it's set to built-in microphone, which is going to record the audio from your laptop. The audio is not very good, but it can give you some scratch audio to sync things up later if you're recording a voiceover. And so I like to leave it on that. And then for options, we have show floating thumbnail. That's when you're done with the entire thing. You're gonna see a little thumbnail down here in this bottom right-hand section. And you could drag it into a folder, or you could drag it onto a hard drive. So that's just up to preference. Remember last selection and show mouse clicks. I like to leave remember last selection on and then showing mouse clicks. I also like to do that for screen recordings so that you can see when I click on something, it does a little circle around it. So it makes it more obvious when I am clicking on a button. And really that's about it. Those are the exact settings that I use. And then you wanna hit record. And this is exactly what I'm doing. I'm now recording this screen. And we'll see up here that we actually have this little stop button. And if I click that, it's gonna stop the recording. And so I'm going to hit that. And we'll see this is the thumbnail that I was talking about in that bottom right hand corner. And if I just kind of slide it away, we'll see it pop up right there on the desktop, which is where I told it that I wanted it. And that is how you screen record. Now, before we get into the tutorial on how to record the internal audio on the computer into those screen recordings, I first wanted to invite you to Grow With Video Live. If you wanna learn how to make money on YouTube and go full time on your dream job, then you should join other serious content creators at our annual conference, Grow With Video Live. Not only are you gonna learn how to start and grow a YouTube channel, but you're gonna be able to connect with people who are gonna support you. And the best part is you can join us from anywhere in the world, so get your tickets today at growwithvideolive.com. Let's get back into the content, but first like this video and comment down below. Let us know if you are coming to Grow with Video Live. We can't wait to connect with you guys at the conference. So the first step you wanna do is hit the link in the description, and that's gonna take you to this page. And then you're just gonna scroll down to right here where you can install, and you're gonna click that link. Now here you're going to fill out your name and email and all that kind of stuff, and this is going to send you an email to download the software. For me, it took a few minutes to get the actual email, so give it a little bit of time. Once you get the email, you can go in, you can click on that link, and from here you're going to download it. You'll open up that package in your downloads and, you know, put in your password and do all that necessary stuff and install the program to your computer. Now once all that's installed, you need to open up the audio MIDI setup. And if we hit Command Spacebar, we can just search for Audio MIDI Setup and open that up. Now there's just a few steps left. The first thing we want to do is go to this plus button down here, and we are gonna create a device by clicking that and hit Create Aggregate Device. Now this first one we are gonna rename by just double tapping on the name, and we're gonna rename it QuickTime Player Input. Here you're gonna wanna select BlackHole 16 channel. Now we are gonna go to the plus button again, and we are gonna make a brand new device, but this time create multi-output device. Once you select that, we're gonna rename it Screen Record with Audio. Now here we wanna select two things. The first thing is we're gonna select built-in output. And then the second thing we are going to want to select is BlackHole 16 channel. And under master device up here, just make sure it's on built-in output. Now on here, you wanna make sure that built-in output is on top of the BlackHole 16 channel. And this is gonna allow you to hear the computer while you are doing your screen recordings. If you don't have this selected, you're not gonna have any audio coming out. And so you're not gonna be able to kind of monitor and hear what's going on. And so we definitely want to select that, and it needs to be up top. And if it is reversed like this, all you need to do is deselect the BlackHole channel, reselect it with built-in output selected first, and that should make sure that built-in output is now on top. From here, we're almost done. What we need to do is go into our system preferences, and then we're gonna go to sound. In sound, we wanna go over to output, and typically it's set to your internal speakers or headphones, whatever is plugged in. We wanna make sure that screen record with audio is selected. And then from there, you can go to your QuickTime movie player, and I'm gonna open that up right now. And we are going to go back to our options. So after going to new screen recording and checking out options, our microphone is set to built-in microphone, but we wanna change that to QuickTime player input. Once you select QuickTime player input for your microphone, you're basically set. You can start recording, and you're going to get all the audio that is happening inside of your computer so that you can listen back and hear what you were hearing on the computer. When you're all done with your recording, you wanna remember to go back into your system preferences, go to sound, and then make sure that your output is back to your internal speakers. This is then gonna let you adjust the volume, and everything is gonna be back to normal. Once you select that, you can exit out and you're good to go. If you're interested in creating video content on your smartphone, then click on the screen right now to check out that playlist, and I'll see you guys in the next video.